So don't make fun of me, but I created this beautiful apparatus, and this is gonna be take two of powering the go-kart with a drone.
I've got an itch I can't scratch, I'm missing a piece that completes a whole part of me, an open wound scar to see. Everybody come here, gather round, welcome to the freak show, the best in town. What the hell's wrong with me? I don't get along with anybody, honestly. I've been living in my own head, constantly thoughts jumbled round, think I need a new lobotomy. Wait, all these thoughts are too negative. I don't wanna get lost in the sedative. Gotta show them what I got, I'm competitive. You know I'm about to go off, I won't let them win. I'll take a stab, I wanna chase a bag. I want a way I can change all the things I lack. I gotta face the facts, I got a taste in that. Got me obsessed with the rest, I got an itch to scratch.
That was a lot of fun. Definitely not the fastest speeds in the world, but proof of concept, everything seemed to work exactly the way I wanted it to, and that's what this engine up here is for. That'll be putting out a lot more power and hopefully give us a lot more speed. And the most important thing, didn't burn up the drill. But now it's time to get back to work. It is unfortunate, but I'm gonna have to rip out this beautiful piece of art right here. I spent a lot of time on it, and I could probably sell it and get a lot of money, but I just don't need it where I'm going. I mean, I even took the effort to grease up these little wear points. It didn't work, but all this needs to come out. I guess I should finally tell you guys what we got planned for today. So I put the old sprockets on that were for that belt, and I used a level, and I wanted to be 100% sure that that engine and that axle are perfectly straight and in line. I bought some sprockets, and I made sure that the gearing ratio between those two sprockets was exactly the same as the gear ratio on that old belt-driven system. And I just went with the chain-driven system, because that means everything on this cart will be using 50 chain, and if I have any maintenance issues or any other issues, it all uses the same parts. And also, belts are extremely expensive, so converting everything over to this chain-driven system costs about the same as just buying a belt for this cart. I'm gonna tear all this apart, and I do need to get this thing to the point where I can take that new axle that we threw in here to a machine shop so they can machine a keyway in it. And that way, on the next video, we'll be able to throw everything in with the keyways, hook it up to the engine, and hopefully get this thing somewhat fired up and see how everything works. Sprocket I ended up purchasing for the engine side is a 7/8 bore sprocket. Now the output shaft on this wet clutch is 22 millimeters, so there is a little bit of slop in here, and the keyways are not the same exact size. So if any of you guys know where I can find an 11 tooth sprocket with a 22 millimeter bore to fit 50 chain, please let me know. Leave it in the comments. That would be extremely helpful. If you thought supporting this axle in the back here was a waste, it wasn't. You can see just how much flex we have in that frame. I know, I already know what every single one of you guys is thinking. Looks like a great way to take off your leg, and I'd have to agree. On the body, that chain runs right through here, so that means all that plastic's gotta go. There's really not going to be a whole lot left to this thing. I've got the body trimmed up at least enough to know that it's going to work. So I'm going to go ahead and remove that. Now that I know exactly what sprocket I'm going to be using, I'm going to go ahead and cut that axle to the exact size I need. And then I think I'm going to solve this loose chain issue. And I'm going to do that by slotting the bottom bearing axles. That way that bottom axle will be able to float and I'll be able to get that tension I need. Unfortunately, I can't slot this top axle because all those brake components are hooked up to that. And if I slot that, that whole rotor is going to be able to float, and I can't have that because the caliper doesn't move in that same direction. So that axle has to stay exactly where it's at, but this bottom one should be able to float. I just hope that when the body goes back on, that rear tire sits somewhere in the center of that wheel well. I slotted those six bearing holes and I was able to slide that axle back about a quarter inch. You can see right in there where that paint line is, where those bearings used to sit. And now we got nice tension on our chain. If we need to add more, we can always pull that axle forward and that'll just tighten those up. So that tire is not perfectly centered in that wheel well anymore, but we'll be able to kind of play with that and slide it back and forth as we need to tension those chains, and it'll work just fine. So everything gets to get tore apart again. I gotta get this upper axle completely stripped down so I can get it sent off to the machine shop. Started mapping out the fuel lines and got a list together of all the stuff I need to order for a video this week, but make sure you guys stay tuned because I have a feeling the next one's gonna be pretty awesome. We're gonna get the fuel lines in and then we're also gonna start working on the pedals, so we're getting pretty close to driving this thing. See you then.